If your WordPress site is not sending emails, or you find that they're ending up in the spam folder, don't worry, because in this video we're going to look at fixing the WordPress not sending emails issue. And we're going to do that by connecting one awesome WordPress plugin and an SMTP service. Hey, I'm Ryan from WP Beginner. If you have a form on your site, like a contact form, then your website will be responsible for sending emails out every time that form is completed. If your website isn't sending emails out, then that can be down to your hosting provider not having the PHP mail function turned on. The best solution for this, and one that we actually recommend even if you don't currently have this issue, is to use the Simple Mail Transfer Protocol, or SMTP, as it's the industry standard for sending emails. Now, this may all sound very technical and beyond the scope of most WordPress website owners, but it really is not, and that's because in this video, we're going to break it down and go step by step. First, we will set up SendLayer, and then we will install the WP Mail SMTP plugin on our WordPress site, and then connect that to SendLayer. I would like to highlight here that SendLayer is a pay-for service, but does offer fantastic value for the features you receive, the ease of use, and the peace of mind that comes with this type of service. They do offer a free trial, so check it out and see if it fits with your needs. Let's head to the SendLayer website and get started. The first thing you want to do when you come to the SendLayer website is sign up for an account. And to do that, you can click the Try SendLayer for Free button right here. That's going to take you to the pricing page. And then if you scroll down on the pricing page, there's a link right here that gives you a free trial and you can send up to 500 emails on that trial. Click that and set up your account. Once you've set up the account, log in. Once you've logged into your dashboard, SendLayer gives you a prompt here to get started. And the first thing we have to do is add our domain. So let's do that. So you just put your domain name in this box and click add domain. Now that we've added our domain, the next thing SendLayer wants us to do is add DNS records to our WordPress website. And that's to authorize our domain and make sure it's super secure. Now I know this seems a little technical, but it's not, because we're going to go through this step by step. And the next thing to do is open another window next to this one so we can copy these DNS records across. So we're going to head over to our hosting provider and find our DNS records. So now we've logged into our hosting provider and we've got the hosting dashboard and SendLayer side by side so we can copy these DNS records across. Now we need to find the DNS manager in our hosting dashboard. For me, that'll be under domains, my domains. This is the domain I'm using, so I'll click on manage. And then under this tab here is DNS, and that's DNS manager. Now with this manager, we're gonna have all of our DNS records, and this is what we're gonna copy across from SendLayer. So the first DNS record here is a CNAME. So we're gonna scroll down to find our CNAME DNS records. We're gonna add our first record. And the host record is going to be our host name here. So our host name here is slstarterwpsite.com. So we're going to copy that. Now I can see under the DNS records that none of them have the starterwpsite.com on them. So that must mean that we don't need it on this record. So I'm just going to delete that from the end of the name. Just call it SL. Points to is going to be the value, so we copy that across. And TTL is set to 24 hours, so we're going to set that to 1 day. Save that record. Okay, we'll add another record as well. So the next one is a CNAME record as well. Copy that name across. Remove the domain name from the end. Copy the value. And set the TTL to 1 day. Now all you need to do is copy the rest of the DNS records over to your DNS manager. I'm going to do that and then we'll jump ahead. So now I've copied all these records over to the DNS manager, the next thing to do is to check this box and verify the DNS records. But please note here, it can take up to 24 to 48 hours for these DNS changes to take place. So if this doesn't verify straight away, you might have to wait a little bit. Now, after you click verify DNS, you should see this screen and you'll see all the DNS records here and their status is right here. And it's indicated by a green tick or a red cross. And if you've got green ticks all the way down, that means the records have changed on your WordPress website and you're ready to move to the next step. Now we're going to go to our WordPress site and install the WP Mail SMTP plugin which is going to make it super easy to connect everything up and make sure it's running properly. To install the WP Mail SMTP plugin, log into your WordPress dashboard and then head to plugins here on the left. Hover over that and then click on add new. Now we're going to head over to the search bar over here and put in WP Mail SMTP. Now the search results have come up. This is the plugin we want right here. I'm just going to click on the install now button. And once that's installed, this button will turn into an activate button and you can click on that. Now that the plugin's activated, it's brought you to this setup wizard here. And we're going to go through this step by step so we can connect SendLayer to our website. So click the let's get started button. As you can see here, SendLayer is one of the recommended mailers, so we're going to click on that. Then we're going to scroll down to the bottom and click save and continue. Now, as you can see, this is configure mailer settings, and this is going to give you a little bit of information about SendLayer and how to get set up, but we've already set up SendLayer, so we don't have to worry about that. First thing it's going to ask us to do is put in the API key. To do that, we can follow this link here and it's going to open SendLayer in a new tab. So this is the API key page in SendLayer. And all you need to do is go over here and click this button to copy the API key. Now head back over to your WordPress website. Now we're back in the setup wizard, we can paste in the API key here. Scroll down. The from name is the name that the emails are sent from, so we can just put the website in for that. I'm going to enable the force from name here so that all my plugins use the same from name for the emails that they sent. Okay, once that's done, we're going to put in a from email, and you want to make sure that it represents the business or company your website is for, and the force from email is checked as well. So we can save and continue. Now this page is just showing you the features that are enabled in WP Mail SMTP plugin. And we've got the light version at the moment, so we've got the first three features checked on. The other two features can be enabled by getting the paid for or pro version of WP Mail SMTP plugin. If you feel like you want these features straight away or at a later time, you can always upgrade and turn these on. Go save and continue. I'm just going to skip this step right here. And this page here is just telling us that we're using WP Mail SMTP Lite, and there's an option to upgrade and add our license key here, but we're going to skip this step. So now we've gone through the wizard and we've set everything up and it's all configured. We just want to send a test email to make sure everything's running properly. To do that, we go to email test up here. And to send a test email, all we need to do is pop an email address into this box here, click the send email button, and then see if we receive that email. So this is what the email looks like once it's been delivered, and now you know everything's set up properly and everything's working. Now that's all set up, you should find your email deliverability hugely increases. And the good thing about SendLayer is you can track all that from the dashboard. I really hope this video helped you fix the WordPress not sending emails issue. If you like this type of content, then I recommend you check out this video next. Thanks for watching.